desi.com.au, the ultimate Australian website for all the Bollywood entertainment, news and info. Why look anywhere else when you can find it all at desi.com.au?
Hello friends and welcome to Desi TV Australia. This is Aarti and I have with me a celebrity who has come all the way from Bollywood. Guys, he has not only worked in the Bollywood movies but also in the Punjabi movies. Not only that, he stepped up and he's also produced the movies of his own. Working in his first movie, Marches, he's been loved since then. Guys, let's all welcome together our very own Jimmy Sherbill. Jimmy ji, first of all, a very warm welcome to Desi TV Australia.
Thank you so much ji. A big hello to all you guys. Sat Sri Akal.
Jimmy ji, all of us would like to know, first of all, how did the transition of name happen from Jasjeet Singh Gill to Jimmy Sherbill?
No, actually, if you watch my first film, that was Marches, you will see my, in the credits, you'll see my name as Jasjeet Sherbill. It's just that while we were shooting for Marches, and then in the middle I was shooting for a film called Jahan Tum Le Chalo, and then finally after 3 years I got Mohabbatein. In the trade, people were always using my nickname as Jimmy Sherbill, Jimmy Sherbill, Jimmy Sherbill everywhere. And by the time we finished Mohabbatein is when I sat down with Aditya Chopra and we were talking about what name to use. So Adi told me that, see Jimmy, the industry, the trade people already know you as Jimmy Sherbill now, because in the trade magazines and everything everywhere, the name was always coming out as Jimmy Sherbill. Because they picked up my name and I think it was easier to spell and easier to use. So I think the trade started using that. And so Adi told me that I think we'll go ahead with Jimmy Sherbill, and that's exactly what happened. And both the names belong to me. I mean, Jasjeet is
so
my name.
It wasn't intentional or anything. It just
It just it's just something that happened.
Jimmy ji, as far as I know, you are a commerce graduate with no acting background.
So no, I have got really no acting background as such, because when I was in school, yes, I used to do a lot of debates and declamations and sometimes some stage performance or something like that. But that those were things that were forced onto me. It was not something that I was doing it. I was doing on my own. But yes, I mean, it was never in school. I never thought that this is what I'm going to do. I mean, till the time I finished my graduation, I was pretty sure that I was going ahead and doing my MBA and probably getting either into family business with my chachas and all and stuff like that, or maybe, you know, set up something on my own and stuff like that. But that was all of a sudden, I mean, like destiny would have it, I found myself in Bombay doing my acting classes with Roshan Taneja Saab. And the moment I started doing those acting classes is when I realized that this is what I want to do in life.
You started with the Hindi movies. How did you move to Punjabi movies and then producing the movies of your own? How did that happen?
No, I was doing my Hindi movies, and you know, when I started off with Marches and Mohabbatein and all, Manmohan Singh ji was the cameraman for Marches also, Mohabbatein also, and later on he started making Punjabi movies,
okay.
Started directing Punjabi films, and that's where Punjabi films started coming into the foray. He made some films with Harbhajan Mann, which were big blockbusters, and suddenly families started going and watching Punjabi films and, you know, stuff like that. And Ji Ayanu was one of them, Masanu Man Watnada. And Manji met me in Bombay once and he said that I have a story in my mind. We met at a function and he said that I have something in my mind. Would you be interested in doing this thing? I said, Manji, I would love to do a Punjabi film, because somewhere I knew that I'm also a Punjabi, and I think Manji is making Punjabi films. I thought that it's going to be good fun. I think it's going to be a great feeling, you know, working with him now this time as he's going to be directing me and stuff like that. So I just went and we shot for this film called Yara Nal Bahana. And I had such a great time because, you know, being in Chandigarh, we finished the whole film was shot in Chandigarh in Himachal. And it just got back memories of the times when I used to be there and we used to go to Manali and, you know, being in Chandigarh.
Yeah.
And the Gedi route, and the film was about that, so there was lots that you know, kind of that was similar, lots that was similar to what had happened to us when we were there in Chandigarh. So I think that's the time I realized that every one and a half years I'm going to try and do one Punjabi film. And I'm going to try and, you know, and I still say that at that point of time, there were about 1% of Punjabis who used to come and watch our Punjabi films. And today, after doing Punjabi films for about 8 to 10 years, I feel that about 7 to 8% Punjabis have started going inside the theaters. And that's why now Bollywood has also started saying that, oh my God, Punjabi films are doing so well. But I still say that 90-92% of people that are still in their homes, the Punjabis who are still in their homes, who still don't go and support Punjabi, the day they come out and start watching Punjabi films, that's the day people will see what kind of a box office Punjabi films can give you.
Dimiji, you've been an actor, you've been a producer. So tell me, what do you like the best?
Being an actor, yeah. Any day being an actor. I think being a producer is a full-time job. It's a very responsible position. And I have been lucky that I've got a very nice team, and they really work hard. They work day and night, and I have to just probably take just a few of the major decisions. Rest of the decisions I can actually rely on them, and I feel that, you know, they can probably take those decisions for me. That, okay, fine. Once we've decided this is the film that we want to do, they know who has to be signed on for what, and this and that and all, whatever, what's the team going to be like, what is the cast going to be like. They just sound me off.
Talking about your family, you have a 10-year-old son, I believe.
Yeah, 9 years old.
So have you seen any inclination in V towards Bollywood movies or anything like that?
No, I think he's a complete sports guy.
He is. Excellent.
And see, in our times, we used to be in the boarding schools and the hostel and stuff like that. So we were, it was compulsory for us to play all the sports.
Yes.
And we used to go season-wise. So when you're in day school, it's all about going to school and coming back. Not many people get into sports. But it's great to see kids these days, at least we, my son, his friends and all that, whatever, going so much into sports. So their day starts with, like, you know, athletics in the morning. Then, you know, afternoon after school, then they have the cricket classes. Then they have, you know, swimming. Then they have tennis, you know, season-wise again in Bombay. So it's a good thing, and we've always encouraged that we is into sports. I mean, it's a great thing. I mean, it gives you a good, it sets a good base for you.
Jimmy Ji, I believe you already had your 40th birthday, if I'm not wrong.
No, I have had my 42nd birthday.
Oh, 42nd birthday. Wow. So tell me the secret behind your fitness, because I was a bit worried to say a 40th, but you're saying 42. So guys, yeah, let's get the secret behind that.
I've normally always tried to you know, go according to what my character demands of me in films, because I think my basic training came from somebody like a Gulzar Saab. And so the only thought process that goes from my side into any film is that, what's the look that my director is looking for? And once that look is decided, I go with that. Mm-hmm. So that's it. I mean, half your battle is won the moment your look is this thing. And then you can, once your look is decided, then you can completely concentrate on your performances and all that, whatever. So putting on and losing weight and stuff like that depends on what film I'm shooting for at that point of time.
Okay.
Yes, in 2011, I had a major problem with my back, my spine and all that, whatever, because of which now I have to be very cautious, because I know that there was a problem in my spine and I have to be very, very careful. I mean, I lost almost a year of mine in 2011 after the release of Dharti, this thing, when I got to know about this problem in my spine. Now I have to take care. It's just that now I've been promoting Rangile for the last 40-50 days already, and been traveling all across the world. I think I've just touched down my house 3-4 times in the middle, which is only for 1 hour, 2 hours, and it's take the connecting flight and out. But that's okay. I mean, this I think I'm doing it after 2 years. 2011 is when I did this for Dharti, and my Punjabi film, and now I'm doing it for this one.
We all know you're here to promote your upcoming Punjabi movie, yeah. Rangile. and which is due to be released on 16th of May, guys. So tell us a bit more about Rangile. One solid reason why people should go and watch Rangile on the big screen.
Well, why one? It's so many. This Neha Dhupia's first film in Punjabi.
Yep.
She's very busy doing Bollywood films, but somewhere I think, you know, when you grow up, you mature, and somewhere, and she belongs to a Punjabi family, she belongs to a Sardar family. Her father was in the Navy, so they were traveling all across India and stuff like that. But I think somewhere your roots do make a difference. And she told me years back, she told me once she was working with me on Delhi Heights, she told me, Jimmy, I want to do one Punjabi film. And I want to do it with you, and I want to do that film as a gift to Punjabis.
Oh, wow.
I felt so emotional. I said, yeah. But then I thought that maybe, you know, sometimes people say it for the heck of it and then just move on. And then she met me again and she said this thing, and that time we were making Dharti. So we just thought that, you know, getting her to do just 5-6 scenes in the film and all that, whatever, and we were already committed to Surveen at that point of time, wouldn't be a good thing. And then again we met at some function in Chandigarh and she saw the first look of Dharti and she was like, I told you I want to do a Punjabi film, what's happening? Then I told my team, I said Namneet and all, and the writer Dheeraj, I told them, please go and meet her because I think she's really serious. And then she met them and she told them also, she said, I'm a Punjabi, I'm a Sardarni, I will take out the time, I will take a, how many days do you want, 30, 35 days, I will take it out because I genuinely want to do it for the Punjabis as a gift from my side because I'm a Punjabi. And that's how it happened. And I think it's a very emotional thing, you know, when these kind of, this is what we have always tried to do, Namneet and myself, we've always, Dheeraj, the writer, we've always tried to get people from Bollywood who are doing really well, they're Punjabis.
Yes.
Prem Chopra, uncle, then Rahul Dev, Ranvijay Singh, Surveen Chawla, these are all people who have made a name in Bollywood and they're all Punjabis.
Yep.
So getting them to do Punjabi films is what we have always tried to do. It does make a difference. A different kind of an audience gets linked to your Punjabi movie. And right now we are at a stage where we are welcoming everybody to our Punjabi films. I go and tell people in Bombay also in all my interviews, I say that our Punjabi films, anybody can understand because Punjabi is so close to Hindi. And when you watch our Punjabi, it's such simple Punjabi that you will enjoy the film. So that's the idea, to get more and more people to come and watch our Punjabi films, because I think somewhere, and this is what I tell everybody, that you know, you might have been, you are a Punjabi, you might be born and brought up over here, but somewhere that pride of being a Punjabi is something that I don't think, you know, anybody else experiences. The love that you get from your fellow people, the respect that they give you, and everything like that. So I think it's a, and this is the least you can do, you know, that just have that feeling of pride that I am a Punjabi and I think I'm proud of that. Okay, and then loki vasde jahan ch bathere Punjabi adi shan vakri. So I think that thing is so right. I mean, you know, everybody is then busy with their own stuff or politics or whatever, and here we are living life and we still have that bonding with each other. I might be in India making movies for you, you're busy over here doing your own stuff and everything like that, but our film in films in Punjabi is what is connecting us all together. So I think for all of you who are shy of going and watching a Punjabi films, please do that, please do go and watch it. When people like us who are Manmohan Singh ji, there's so many other people who are busy in their own lives in Bollywood and everything like that, we try and come back and do Punjabi films for the passion of it, for the fact that it's our duty to do that. We do expect you guys also to come out and, you know, probably this thing. Don't think of the fact that you won't understand. There's subtitles down below. You can read that and understand the subtitles in English. And then plus, even if there's no age that you can actually not learn a language, I think you go watch Punjabi films, a couple of them, and you'll probably,
you know,
be
Punjabi.
Yeah.
Excellent. Jimmy ji, before we go, just a quick message to all the viewers watching you on Desi TV Australia.
Well, I would just like to say thank you to all of you who have always given such a great response to our Punjabi films. The love that you give us. I think because of you, we are there. And for all the people who have not yet watched any of our Punjabi films, here's another chance. 16th of May, Rangile is coming out. Go watch it. I'm sure you're going to enjoy, because this film is full-on entertainment. There's something for everyone. You can go with your kids, with your elders, with families, because our Punjabi films are very clean and wholesome entertainment. So go enjoy yourself. There's some nice music, song and dance. 2 hours of entertainment every second. Not even 1 second will you get bored. And go see the Punjab that is there today, and the kind of love stories that come up over there, the kind of fun that is happening over there. You'll get to see all that stuff.
Excellent, Jimmy ji. Thank you so much for your time. We wish you all the very best.